Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2007, Up, Down Markers. Yeah, I'll be podcasting this entire book. Click that I in the top right-hand corner to subscribe. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gellin. This is not one of the 40 tips in the book. It's one of the bonus tips between the other tips, because after showing yesterday's podcast of how to compare three lists, I said, boy, it'd be really nice if we had some indicator if we were up or down. And so conditional formatting icon sets came along in Excel 2007, but not all of these. They added a few of them in Excel 2010. And one that I remember that they added in Excel 2010 was this one that they call three triangles, which, look at it, it's not three triangles at all. It's two triangles and a dash. Anyway, this indicates up, down, or flat. But how the heck are we supposed to use this? Because icon sets can't look at any other cells. They only look at the cell where the icon appears. So it doesn't know if it's up or down. So here is my crazy trick that I use for this. I'm going to copy these headings out here to be helper cells. All right. And here I'm going to build a formula that is equal M7 minus L7. Now, why did I type that instead of using the mouse or arrow keys? Because I don't want get pivot data to happen. All right. So I'm going to copy that formula all the way throughout like this. Bam. And actually, probably even the grand totals too. Okay, now that gives me a wide variety of numbers, plus 3, minus 2, 0, and I need this to be three numbers. I need it to say either it was up, it's positive, it was down, it was negative, or it was flat, which is 0. So I'm going to use the sine function, but not the one from trigonometry, not S-I-N, S-I-G-N. S-I-G-N says we're going to do that math, and then it's either something going to be minus 1 for negative, 0 for 0, or plus 1 for positive. All right, that's beautiful. Now, here in the helper cells, we're going to do conditional formatting, icon sets, three triangles, also known as two triangles and a dash, and we get our indicator showing whether we're up, flat, or down. Now, I need to get rid of the numbers. So, conditional formatting, manage rules, edit the rule, and say, show icon only. That also is brand new in Excel 2010. See, and that gives us now an arrow up, arrow down, or flat. In real life, we would have built this way out there off the right-hand side of the screen so no one else would ever see it. We're going to copy these cells, Control-C. We're going to come here to our pivot table. I want the indicators to show up on Tuesday or Wednesday, and we're going to do something really cool, paste a linked picture. All right. Now, in order to make this work, this column width has to be the same as this column width. So I'm going to copy these two columns, Control-C, and then come over here. I'm going to use Paste Special and paste the column widths. And it's almost good, except for we're seeing the grid lines. Let's just turn the grid lines off. I could come out here and get rid of yeah, let's just turn grid lines off, make it look better. You know, and now that I look at this, yeah, I'm not a big fan of the big yellow dash to indicate flat. So back here, select all of these, home, conditional formatting, manage rules, edit the rule, and we're going to say no cell icon for the center one. Click OK. Click OK. All right. Now, if there was ever a weird case where everything was down, there were no ups at all, and all you had was zeros and ones, then you definitely might want to come in and take the extra time to manage these rules, edit the rule, change this from percent to number, where it's greater than. You'd say, well, if it's greater than zero, you get this. If it's greater than or equal to zero, no cell icon, and then everything less than zero will get the down arrow, right? But provided you have a mix of increases and decreases, the other way is probably safe. I take that back. No, it's not safe. Always to take the extra time to make sure, because sooner or later there's going to be someone where, you know, everyone bails out and all the R3Ps are down and you don't have any ups. So go ahead, take the extra time to do that. Also, did you notice that the camera tool wasn't updating? This is another bug. Oh man, so I'm on the first release programs. That means I get new bits, but for some reason that wasn't updating. I selected the camera tool, came here, just pressed enter, and that seemed to force it to recalc. I don't know what's up with that. Very bizarre. All right, well, hey, this bonus tip plus 40 real tips plus a whole bunch of bonus tips plus other stuff is in this book. Go buy the book. 10 bucks for an ebook, 25 bucks for the real book. It's in color, lots of fun stuff here. All right, episode recap. Icon sets. They debuted in Excel 2007, but it was 2010 when they added the set with up, flat, and down. But how can you use it to compare two cells because the icon can only look at one cell? Created two helper columns off to the side, used a calculation to show the change, and then converted that calculation using the sign, S-I-G-N function, to make it plus 1, 0, and minus 1. Add the three triangles. Why do they call it three triangles when it's really two triangles and a dash? Edit the rule. Use greater than 0 for the green up arrow, greater than or equal to 0 for the yellow dash. All the negative numbers will get the red arrow. You want to copy the column widths from the original cells to the helper cells. I did that with paste special column widths. Copy those helper cells. Paste this linked picture. It's down under the paste drop down. It used to be called the camera tool. Turn off the grid lines with view grid lines. And then maybe take out the dash. Manage rules, edit rule, use no cell icon for the dash. The camera tool didn't update, so I had to click the camera tool, click in the formula bar, and press enter to get it to update. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. I'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.